guys are back again with another instalment on the organisation series, and this time it's just wanted to talk to you about how I sort of organise my health and lifestyle and everything like that. If you follow my other channel, Ginger Juice, a link's in the description below. You'll know that I've kind of you'll see that I posted sort of a video. In fact, I'll link the video down below about sort of getting back in touch with your body and looking after your health, etc. And I'm a big girl, and I've always been big, and I do have sort of like some hormonal issues going on as well. And so for me, I need to watch what I eat and what I eat, you know, how much, etc. And I'm having a bit of a real push at the moment before Christmas to lose some weight. And yeah, so basically I kind of want to manage, you know, what I eat. I mean, in the past I have had a little bit of a gluten intolerance as well, which seems to have sort of sorted itself out. But anyway, I just like to kind of really kind of keep on track of my body and know what my body's doing and try and look after myself. So previously I've been using this little notebook, and so basically I write down everything that I eat. Well, I try to write down everything that I eat in a day, just so that I'm kind of more conscious about what I'm eating and the calorie content in things, because otherwise I get a bit too, say, carried away with stuff. So, you know, this book just usually sits downstairs on my breakfast bar in the kitchen, and every time I eat something I kind of write it, like the day, I write down what I've had, and then I write down the calorie contents, and I try to stick to, obviously the average calorie intake for a woman is 2,000, but I try and stick as close to 1,500, 1,800 as possible, because I am trying to lose weight. That being said, if I do go over, I don't beat myself up about it. So yeah, so I just write everything down that I've had, and then a column for the calories. On this side I've just written juice and the calorie content, and on the other side I write down like the components of the juice and then work out what the total is. So that's what I have been doing. And if you've seen like my other videos, you'll know that I had like basically loads of different journals and notebooks and everything, this being one of them. And I just with the Filofax and my new push for getting everything organized, I just thought I would get rid of this book. You know, I've already got my I'll just zoom out again for you. I've already got my Filofax, which is kind of coming around the house with me. I basically leave it either on my desk upstairs next to my computer, or I take it downstairs and it sits on the breakfast bar. It doesn't ever really go out of the house, you know, it's a big one, as I've said in the past series. So I thought I would just combine all my diary calorie counting stuff into my Filofax. But also I've created some other inserts for kind of helping me manage and motivate myself with, you know, other aspects of my health. So I just thought I would show you how I've done it. You know, again, I do sell these inserts. At the moment I've just got, at the time of recording, not necessarily the time of uploading this video, but at the time of recording I've just got the one health set I've listed on Etsy, which is the bunny set. But I do plan on doing all the ones I've currently got in that health set as well, if you know what I mean, like the kitties and the ladybugs and stuff. But I've just done the one at the moment because I did it for myself. I created them for myself, and then I just thought, you know, someone else might be interested, so I'll put them in my shop. So this isn't a sales plug, I just wanted to show you. As with all my videos, if you'd like to buy the inserts, that's lovely, but just to reiterate, this isn't a sales video. I just want to show you how I do it, how I've organised myself, and the inserts I've made, and how I'm doing that, basically. So let's crack on. So I've got my health tab in the Filofax here. And these tabs are working really well for me. I'm really loving them. They're really quick and easy to go to. So yeah, we'll flick through and let's see. Okay, so the first page is a bit shorter because I was a bit scissor happy and I cut it a bit shorter. Is a goals and aspirational page, and it's printed on coloured card because I wanted it sort of thick and durable, something that I would instantly see, and you know, so I wanted it to kind of like stand the test of time really in my Filofax. But I basically wanted to put that in there so that every time I open my Filofax, I'm kind of reconfirming what I'm doing and why I'm doing it, because I know that I, you know, can very easily go off track, and I'm really committed. I've made a commitment to myself that I want to eat better and feel better and live well, so I kind of want to put that in there to reconfirm it all the time to myself and to try and keep myself on track. And you know, I'm really going for a real good push at the moment. Those of you that have followed my videos for a while will know that last year I was really poorly, I'm asthmatic anyway, and I've had asthma ever since I was a child, and last year I also got pneumonia, and I got pneumonia quite bad, and I also got a collapsed lung, and I was in hospital for a while, and took me quite a while to recover, and then in March I had another relapse again, and so I've just been kind of, you know, trying to get myself well and better again, and so I spent quite a few months kind of just not really doing that much exercise, and I put on quite a bit of weight, and you know, I'm just feeling really sluggish again, but now I'm all pleased to say that I'm all well, and you know, the doctors have put me on the right medicine and it's all really working well for me. So I'm doing a real big kind of push. I want to get back to the person that I was before I was ill last year. So, you know, that's what I'm kind of doing. You don't need a new year to start resolutions, do you? So it's kind of all about you being committed. And so to reconfirm my commitment is why I've put everything down, and I'll just read you what's online in case you're interested. So because I can't really tell if it's very clear on the screen or the video or not. So to feel confident and healthy in my body again, that's because I had been feeling really sluggish. I just wanted to start moving my body around. To drink more water a day. I am quite bad at that sometimes. I mean, I do like water, but you know, sometimes I can get a couple of hours have gone by and I haven't, you know, and I'm getting engrossed in something that I haven't drunk. So I want to drink more water a day. I want to meditate and relax more and take more baths. That's to kind of like have some me time and, you know, and kind of, yeah, self-explanatory really. To eat my 5 a day, every day. We all have good intentions, I think, but not always, you know, so I am trying to make sure I do that. And if you follow my other channel, my Ginger Juice channel, you will, you'll know that I'm really trying to get back into my body as well. Like, I post a couple of videos, which I'll link below, on like, you know, fitness and getting back in touch with my body, and also like juicing and stuff. So I'm getting there. To move my body more and exercise 3 times a week, because I don't necessarily enjoy exercise. But it's kind of, I know I've got to do it, so I want to do it. I feel better once I've done it. So yeah, just kind of, you know, come on, girl. Stop snacking in the evening. That's a big downfall for me, is snacking in the evening. And also to eat breakfast. I don't feel hungry when I wake up in the morning, but then I feel hungry mid-morning and really go for the food. So I'm trying to, you know, eat healthy. So anyway, it's just, as I say, it's there, and I can see it every time I open my journal up. The next thing, the medication chart. I take my preventative inhaler twice a day. I also take my tablets in the morning for my asthma. and my reliever when I need it. And so I'm in a routine with that, so I don't log that or anything. But if at any other time I need to take any medication, for example, back in September, I got a wee bit of a cold, to be honest. And I'm not very good at like remembering when I've taken, you know, like paracetamol or something. So I'm just trying to focus up here. So I've done myself a medication chart so that I can write. I don't actually can see this because it's in green pen. I hope you can. So I've got like the date there, like the 23rd of September. I took a Lemsip sachet, and it was the max strength one. And then I just had that at 9 o'clock at night. And then the next day, the 24th, I had it again. Had it at 10 o'clock in the morning, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and then 10 o'clock at night. So I basically, in the morning, I logged it. I had it at 10 because, you know, it's like when you've got a cold, come like 12 o'clock, you know, you could feel rough again, but, you know, you can't take your Lemsip for another, paracetamol for another 4 hours. But you kind of forget when you took it. Well, I do anyway. I don't want to like generalise, but I forget when I take it. So then I just write it down. I took it at 10 and then I know that, you know, I can write down when I next can have a dose. So that kind of works for me. And kind of also, I mean, when I was in hospital, I my husband sort of had to, you know, when I came out of hospital, I was on quite a few drugs, and my husband sort of kind of, I was a bit out of it. So my husband kind of had made a version of this for himself, of the medicine that I was taking and when I was taking it, because I was just sleeping all the time. So then I, when I was well, I made this for kind of him to use for me, but luckily I don't need it anymore, and it's kind of just me as a safe, like cold medicines and stuff. And then down here I've just put a note, symptom, side effects section, you know, just in case. So that's sort of medication. I've just put a post-it over my address, obviously, but I just keep my a copy of my repeat prescription. I do my repeat prescriptions online, actually, but I just got a copy of it in here just in case internet's not working and I need to go and put a repeat prescription in or anything like that. And I also keep in here as well, I've got the login details of the internet, of how to get my repeat prescriptions, but I've just taken them out for the video, obviously, for it's got all my confidential data. I mean, I don't mind you seeing what medication I'm on, because it's just asthma stuff, but, you know, seeing my NHS number and my doctor's surgery address and everything is a no-no, isn't it? So I hope you understand that, but that's just a bit of paper with it written on, really. So then I've got, so that's kind of like medication side. Then I've got sort of like a semi-divider, another piece of purple card again, with just an inspirational quote, because I do need that. I do need a kind of a little push and a nudge now and then. And I've made several of them, but the one I've got in at the moment is this one, which is, weight loss is like driving. If you ever veer off the road, just make a U-turn and head back in the right direction. And then I put unknown because I don't know who it was by. I found it on Pinterest and there was no credit. So if this is, if you know the origins of this one, let me know, because obviously I'd like to credit the person. The postman's just been. I thought he was knocking on the door, but you just put something through, so that's cool. So yeah, if you know the origins, let me know. But I like this quote and it's very true to me, which is why I put it in, because if I've been naughty, if I'm gonna fall off, I'm gonna fall off big style. So I kind of need that thing that if you have had a bad day, it's okay, don't worry, the next day you can be good again, you know, whereas I need to keep telling myself that, because otherwise, or if I've had, like, say at lunchtime I've been really naughty and had something, I'll be like, oh, sod it, the day's lost now, I might as well just be really bad all day. But that's not the case, is it? Just because you've had a bad lunch doesn't mean you have to have a bad dinner and snacks as well. So it's in there to remind me constantly. So I've made myself a weight loss tracker, because I'm a visual person and I really like to kind of... the better I'm doing, like the more weight I've lost, the more it encourages me, the more I'll lose, if you see what I mean. So when I can see that I'm doing well, I am more motivated to do well. I don't know if that's, I'm articulating that well, but just basically that, like here, for example, I can see the line, I've plotted the a graph of how much I've lost. I can see it going down, and I'm sort of a bit competitive with myself. So I can see it going down. I want to get to that next line, and then I want to get to that next line. And I want to get to that next line. So it's kind of, I'm using it to kind of motivate and compete and compete with myself. So I made this. It's basically, I've got pounds down the side, and then dates across, and you know, I can print these off at any time and just write them in so I can change them. I mean, I lost a pound recently, but before that I was losing them in £3 sections, which, so I wrote them in £3 sections up there, and as you can see, I'm really close to losing a stone, which I'm really excited about, which I put there in green. When I get to there, that's a stone, so I'm really close, and that's motivating me, you know, because I can see it there, and I want to get, I want to get there. And as you can see, I started recording this one on 13th of September. So, and I weigh myself once a week on a Friday, and then I come and then I fill out my tracker after I've done that. Like, you know, as I said, this sits on my breakfast bar, and I just fill this out after I've weighed myself and while I'm having breakfast. So the next thing I've done is I wanted to keep a track of my measurements and how much I've lost. Now I do have a completed version of this, but I wasn't really comfortable showing you all the data, so I've just printed off a fresh clean one. So basically, it's got a date column, the weight, so the actual amount I weigh. That other tracker I just showed you, this one, shows you how many pounds I've lost, but not what my actual weight is. And I'm really happy to share with you that I've lost weight, but I'm not comfortable saying what I actually weigh. My weight and then my measurements, you know, like centimetres or inches. So I've got bust, waist, hips, my bra size and my clothes size. And I'm just keeping those in that information to myself right now, but I just wanted to show you how I do it. And then on the other side, so I've just printed those out double-sided. Again, it's a weight loss tracker, and I've just kind of printed a new one of this and omitted the actual information on how much I weigh. I know what a wuss. So I've put the date in there, and I've put in how much I've actually lost, but left off the how much I actually weigh, because I'm shy. And I have a comment section. Like, it's, you know, it's kind of good to look back on. Like, if you put on weight, you can kind of say why, and also how you're feeling to motivate you. So, like, I only lost a pound, but then I know, I mean, I didn't do as much exercise that week as the week that I lost 4 pounds. And I just wanted to keep kind of a track of that, basically, so that, you know, I can look back on and go, right, okay, what do I need to do next week if I want to lose more weight? You know, and I find that really helpful. I really find that helpful for me. I personally need that constant kind of inspiration and push and validation. That's just me. So moving on to like looking at the actual fitness rather than just diet. I have a exercise and fitness sort of timetable tracker, just to kind of, again, so I can actually visually see it. I can actually visually see how much exercise I've done, and if there's nothing on that week, I know that's naughty. So if we got to Friday and the rest of the week's blank, I know that that's bad. This is blank because it's a brand new week and I've just printed one off. So basically I have weeks down the side, sorry, day of the week down the side. And then I've got time of day of the exercise, duration. So, you know, I mean, even if you only do like 15 minutes running on the Wii, you know, you don't have to do an hour's exercise class. That's still exercise, isn't it? So duration, type of exercise, you know, like yoga or running, exertion level, approximate calories burned. I mean, the Wii tells you, doesn't it? The Wii Fitness tells you approximate calories burnt. And it's just, I mean, I don't kind of take that as in, oh, I've burnt 200 calories, I can go and eat 200 calories. I don't do that. But it is kind of useful to see how many calories you're burning compared to how much you're eating. Like, when, you know, it's quite shocking, really, isn't it? Like a slice of bread is about 100 calories. But to burn 100 calories, you have to do how much, however much running or whatever. You know, it's quite interesting to look at, I think. And then also my feelings, mood, attitude, comments, that kind of thing. So, like, how I was feeling afterwards and all that just kind of helps me to keep on track, really. And then lastly, I just printed off my calorie tracker sheet. Let's zoom out again and focus. I have to manually focus this camera, so... So yeah, so basically, as I was saying, I had this book. I've now put everything into the Filofax. And so yeah, I've just started it for the day I filmed. This is the 4th of October. So I've only just had my breakfast, so you can see. So I put the day and the date in there, 4th of October. The calories allowance, so I want to eat no more than 1,800 today. And then I have a little box for each. So I've got breakfast, mid-morning snack, lunch or dinner, mid-afternoon snack, dinner or tea, supper or evening snack. So that's all the, you know, all the sections. Then I've got a column for like your quantity, so like your grams or your millilitres, and then how many calories. So I've had 100 mils of semi-skim milk, which was 50 calories, and then I had a bowl of ready breck, 300 grams of ready breck, 112, so I added up, so for breakfast I had 162 calories. So I've got a subtitle section, and that's the same for each box. And then when we get down to the very end, I've got a total calories for the day, so I can look at that. And then also down the bottom here, I've got a fruit and veg portions, so I can tick off every time I have some fruit or veg, and tick off how I've got an 8 sections for glasses of water. So yeah, so I can see, and then I've got the choice. I can either leave them in here or I can take them out. I've just, for the purposes of this video, I've taken all the others out because you don't need to see a massive wad of past days. So yeah, so that's it, basically. That's how I kind of try and keep on touch and make myself be good, and how I organise my health and my diet and my fitness. So if you've got any ideas or suggestions, I always love hearing from you guys. Just let me know, and I'll pop the links in the comment section below for the other videos that are kind of related or you might be interested in on my other channel. And of course, do go and check out the other parts in this series on this channel, on the organisational series. So that's it for now. So thanks for watching, guys. Bye.